2 hours from here, from our bishop's house in Sweden. And it was the mass for the parishioners, the Catholics, and the non-Catholics meeting together. They were all together about 5,000 persons. And the non-Catholic was present at the mass with much devotion. And after the mass, I went out of the church. And I felt someone touching my hand, touching my shoulders. And certain moment I asked, when I go to the parishes, I have always have two seminarians who got really to help me stay there so that I can be free to meet the people. I asked the seminarians who came with me or behind me. Someone touched my hand and my shoulder. They answered, many people touch your hand with your shoulder and then they touch their body. That is the part where we hurt. I imagine the scene of Jesus described in the Gospel. Bishop is the man, but they don't see the bishop as a man. But that is the man of God. The need of God in the people. That is the call, aspiration of the people. Even when you have the governor of the state to go to visit, people do not receive governor as they receive a bishop. Very different. Because they feel the sense of the divine through the person. They behave themselves with the priests, different with the doctors. Even if they are sick and they need the medical doctors. But their attitude before the medical doctors is very different from their attitude toward the priest. And a young priest or religious sister, very young, the religious sister just professed the first profession. The young priest had just been ordained, and he told a person of age of his grandparent, grandfather, grandmother. People pray first upon the priest or religious sisters, and after that man or that woman, they feel something, they need the divine presence, particularly in persons. Therefore, I would like to recall here an affirmation of Evangelii Nuntiandi, of the Blessed Paul VI, Evangelii Nuntiandi 76, the one which paradoxically, despite innumerable signs of the denial of God, is nevertheless searching for him in unexpected ways and painfully experiencing the need of him. The word is calling for evangelizers to speak to him of a God whom the evangelists themselves should know and be familiar with as if they could see the invisible. The word calls for and expects from us simplicity of life, the spirit of prayer, charity towards all, especially towards the lowly and the poor, obedience and humility, detachment and self-sacrifice. Without this mark of holiness, our world will have a difficulty touching the heart of modern man. It risks be vague and sterile. But that is the deep aspiration of the people. Even Pope Paul VI said, even they seem to deny God, but painfully they need God. But now there is another desire, deeper. That is the sight of God. And that is the reason, the origin of all the catechesis of the life of the church. Not simply the aspiration for the people. Because many times people seem not to want God, therefore not to want the church. But God wants the people. I would like to recall here a text from Isaiah. Chapter 6, verse 8, very simple. Then I heard the voice of the Lord say, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? And I said, here I am, send me, O Lord. The second text I would like to recall here is the text from the Gospel of St. Matthew. If Jesus went throughout all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, in proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every disease and every affliction. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like a sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, the harvest is plentiful. Is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray earnestly to the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. God wants to save you, but God needs his disciples. The people who goes in his name. That is his deep inspiration. Isaiah heard the voice of God. I hear the voice of God who said, who shall be sent? Who goes for us? And Isaiah responded, here I am, send me. Throughout the history of the church, there have been always persons who have been able to hear the voice of God. In among them, I would like to quote here one author, very known, well known by many people, Vision Post. I would like to read. It seems to me Vision Post is another Isaiah who is able to hear the voice of God and respond to God. Son, you are not alone. I am with you. For I needed another human being to continue my incarnation and my redemption. Out of all eternity, I chose you. I need you. I need your hands to continue to bless. I need your lips to continue to speak. I need your body to continue to suffer. I need your heart to continue to love. I need you to continue to save. Stay with me. And that is the voice which Bishop Post could hear. Now, the answer. Here I am, Lord. Here is my body, my heart, my soul. Grant that I may be big enough to reach the world, strong enough to carry it, pure enough to embrace it without wanting to keep it. Grant that I may be a meeting place, but a temporary one, a road that does not end in itself. Because everything to be gathered there, every here I am, hold on. From this reality of the profound aspiration of the humanity, but sometimes because of the emotions, because of the passions, this aspiration may be hidden, but it's always there. So before this reality, there is always the desire of God, who I am at the door and I knock at the door. Those who open the door for me, I will enter and I will have a supper with him and eat with me. So what is the task of the catechesis? I would like to take the answer from the Evangelium Sanctum, number 44. It is very evident, but in reality, sometimes it is not evident. There are three tasks which are complementary in the catechesis, according to Evangelium Sanctum. The first task is to teach, systematically present the gospel, because when the ideas are separated, they are not strong enough. When they are bound together in a system, they will be strong to resist on the tentative of theories which contradict. So the first task is to explain the mystery of Christ to the people. And explain it in a systematic way. The second task